Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And if today is the first time you are coming here, you are welcome. Welcome. Please don't forget to subscribe by clicking the red button and also hitting the notification bell beside it, so that whenever I make a post, you'll be the first to get notified. Okay, thank you. So guys, in today's video, I'll be sharing with you some of the Nigerian slangs and their meaning. This video was actually inspired by Prudence Apinoku. I watched her video the other day. So here is my own version of Nigerian slangs and their meanings. Alright guys, let's get into this video. So guys, in case you see me looking down, yes, I wrote them out for you people, okay? I do not want to forget anyone, so I wrote all of them out. I actually compiled over 40 of them, yes, and I know that there are still some that I didn't remember, okay? So after watching this video and you realize that I omitted some, please drop them in the comment section. I also want to learn. So the number one on my list is hammer. Hammer simply means striking wealth, okay? So if you hear someone say, I go hammer this year, the person is just trying to say, I must make it this year. Yes. Number two, abego. Abeg means please, but after writing please, you put O, it means abego. Next one is everywhere stew. Everywhere stew simply means everywhere is fine, okay? Everywhere is good. Dropping. This dropping is mainly used for road transportation, okay? When you are in a bus or in a taxi and you want to drop, you want to alight, okay? Dropping simply means alighting, okay? You want to come down from the bus. You just say, oh, guy, they drop. Oh, I want to drop. I'm dropping. So that dropping means alighting. Ojoro. Ojoro means cheating. Yes, ojoro means cheating. So when you hear this one now, ojoro, when you hear this one now, ojoro, the person is just saying this one is cheating. If you do anyhow, you go see anyhow. It simply means watch how you behave with me or watch how you talk to me. Okay, when you see two people in an argument and one person says, if you do anyhow, you go see anyhow, the person is simply saying, whatever you give to me, I will give back to you. No pour sand for my gari simply means don't burst my bubble, okay? Nor use your reggae spoil my bliss. Don't come and turn my good situation to worse. Yes. How body? How body simply means how are you? How are you? How are you doing? And you want to reply in a joking manner, then you say body day inside clothes. Okay, how body? Body day inside clothes meaning how are you? I am fine. Yes, body day inside clothes means I am fine. Dash is when someone likes something you have. Maybe you have a shoe or a cloth or anything that belongs to you at all, okay? And the person admires it, the person will just say dash me, meaning give me. Ajebota or ajebo, this one refers to those who were born with a silver spoon, aka the rich kids, okay? They are the ajebotas. Then the opposite of ajebotas are the ajebako. They are jibakos. They are the opposites of ajibota. So if ajibota is those that we are born with a silver spoon, you already know what ajibako is. The next one is shark. Shark. I want shark. If you hear I want shark, just know that the person is saying I want to drink. Shark means drink. Like play, jokingly. Okay? This means jokingly. You can say like play, these people don't marry. Meaning, jokingly, these people are married. Or like play, these people don't born. No. Jokingly, they already have a child, okay? Or maybe when you do something that you didn't know you could actually do it, can say, like play, I don't do this thing. No. Meaning, jokingly, you actually did it. The next one is last. Last is like at the end, okay? At the end, say, last, we go there all right. Last, everybody will be all right. The next one is who you help. This who you help is usually used for people that feel that they are not on anybody's level, okay? So when someone is feeling like she's on top of the world, you now tell the person who you help, meaning who have you helped. Busybody is someone that does everything but mind his or her business, always going from one place to the other, okay? Looking for what to gist or what to talk about. That person is busybody. Jara means extra. Put extra. I beg, put jara. It's usually used in the market, okay? If you go to buy something in the market and you want the person that is selling the stuff to put extra for you, that is adding extra to the quantity you already bought, you can just say, put jara for me now. Put jara. Jara means extra. Wayo and the Ojoro, they are the same thing. They all means cheating. Wayo means cheating. Ojoro means cheating. So if I say, this thing you are doing is wayo, I'm just saying this thing you are doing is cheating. Awoof. Awoof and Oshofri. Oshofri. Hear something like, you too like awoof. The person is just telling you that you like freebies, okay? You like free things. But Oshofri is someone who lives on free things. Someone whose career or whose job is to live on free things. That person is Oshofri. Shine your eye, you. Shine your eye. When you hear shine your eye, just know that they are telling you to be careful, be observant. Maybe you are going to somewhere that is new to you, okay? And someone is telling you, shine your eye, or the person is just trying to say, be careful, be vigilant, open your eyes and look well, observe. Kasala, yawa, kasala, they mean trouble, okay? When you hear kasala don't bust means there is trouble, or yawa don't gas, it also means there is trouble. Ovasabi is someone that knows everything. Someone that knows, people that believe they know everything. They are the omni-knowest. Domots means a space in front of your house, okay? Like, in front of your house, you have a space, yes. That space is what is called domot in Nigeria. So if you hear something like, who keep this thing for my domot? I beg, come out this thing for my domot. It means take this thing away from my house, or take this thing away from my space. Come out for my domot. Go away from my space. Farms or farmsing. Farmsing is trying to, how do I put this word? Farmsing means sucking up to someone, okay? Sucking up to someone. You don't really like that person, but you are still sucking up to them to show people that you are really connected with them, whereas you don't like them. Mado. So this one actually came into existence this year. Yes, mado. When you hear mado, that the person is just saying extremely nice. Yes, that is mado. Amibo, aproko, and the busybody. They are the same. They are in the same family group. So they actually mean one that goes about looking for where to bring gist and drop gist, like minister of information. You know, that kind of thing. Yes. That is amiibo and aproko. How far? How far also means how are you? So how far comprises of many things. In Nigeria, how far? This how far, it means a lot, okay? This how far means how are you. This how far means how far you have gone. This how far means, in fact, it means so many things. So when you hear how far, just flow with anyone. You can just say, I day. How far, how are you? I day means I am fine, okay? So when the person now says, how far about what we talked about, then you know the person is asking for an update of what you've already discussed, okay? That is also how far. How far means so many things in Nigeria. Na you sabi or na you know? This one is simply saying you are on your own. Okay, maybe you are trying to indulge someone in some kind of discussion and the person is not interested, the person doesn't want to talk about it. The person can just say, "Na you sabi o," or "Na you know." Yes, you're your own. She doesn't know what you're talking about. That is na you sabi. Bad belle. Bad belle is not a good one. Bad belle basically means envy. Okay, when you hear this person na bad belle de tuam, just say this person is jealous. Yes, bad belle means jealous or envy. Tie wrapper, tie gele. This one actually means the trouble is too much or the matter on ground is too much. Okay, so when you hear the matter tie wrapper, the person is actually saying the matter is too much or the issue is too much. Abi, she, ba, they mean the same thing. Abi, just like right, she, right, ba. So you may hear something like you are coming, abi, meaning you are coming, right? Next one is naso. This naso means the person is concurring. Okay, let me use concurring, or the person is concurring to whatever you are saying. As when you are gisting someone, the person will say naso. Yes, the person is concurring to your discussion. Kolo. This kolo means crazy or craze. Yes, so if you hear something like you de kolo, person is just saying craziness is starting to manifest in your life. I go change them for you. This one is simply saying I will change it for you. Mind how you talk to me, else I will change it for you. Don't bring that to my side. Don't bring that your attitude to my side, else I will change it for you. Fold my hand. Fold my hand basically means disappointment. Okay, maybe when you already have an expectation from someone, you're already expecting someone to do something in a certain way, okay, and the person did not do it the way you expected, and you say you just fold my hand, meaning you disappointed me. Yes. Bone face means frowning. Okay, why you de bone your face? Why are you frowning? As in is in synonymous with naso. Yes, you are concurring to someone's discussion. You are just affirming like what the person is saying is true. The person will be talking, you say as in yes, like true, like really. The last one is nothing do you. This nothing do you means you are okay. If you hear something like nothing do you, the person is just saying you are very okay, you are good to go. That is nothing do you. So guys, this is the end of this video and I hope you like it. Let me know the ones I did not remember in the comment section. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you all in my next video. Bye.